Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone, how are you today? I hope you always keep health yourself, right? The first one, notable our lecture of the literature in ELT. Okay. And all my friend, be happy. Okay, the first, in the today, I will present about lesson plan. Okay. Okay. Here, I will explain about the branch of lesson plan. The first one, there is definition of lesson plan, and the second one, the purpose of lesson plan, and the third one, the tools of lesson plan. And the fourth, the step of lesson plans. And the fifth, assessment of learning result, and the last is conclusion. Okay, entering of the first branch, that's about definition of lesson plan. Lesson plans is a process of planning that a teacher does before carrying out the teaching learning activity. So, a lesson plan is a process, right, for teaching to our student. Okay. Next to the second branch, that's about the purpose of lesson plan. Here, there is six. There are six. Point in my lesson plan. The first one is identifying threats of giving and asking for information regarding identity and family relationship. Okay, yang pertama tujuannya yaitu untuk mengidentifikasi mungkin ungkapan-ungkapan dari memberi atau meminta informasi baik terkait jati diri atau hubungan keluarga. Oke, okay. And the second, identifying the different ways of expression of each context. Kemudian tujuan yang kedua yaitu mengidentifikasi perbedaan cara penggunaan dari masing-masing konteks. And the third, understanding the structure of the process text. Ya, jadi untuk yang tujuan ketiga itu memahami structure dari bahasa frase yang ada dalam teks tersebut, dan menanyakan informasi yang mungkin ada dalam kalimat tersebut. And the fourth one, that's understanding the language element of the phrase give and ask information. That's memahami unsur kebahasaan dari ungkapan memberi dan meminta informasi terkait jati diri or family relationship. And the next, regarding identifying identity and family relationship sentence for information on identity and family friends. Nah, jadi untuk tujuan yang kelima yaitu mengenai menyusun kalimat meminta informasi terkait dirinya, ya, diri si student atau keluarga dan temannya. And next, responding the request for information regarding his identity and family. Dan yang terakhir, tujuan terakhir yaitu menanggapi permintaan informasi terkait dirinya atau dalam keluarganya. That's about the purpose of my lesson plan and enter to the third branch. That's about the tools of lesson plan. Okay, I use the tools on my teaching. We can use a marker and then whiteboard and laptop and in focus, yeah, so that the student can understand my explanation when we teach to them. Yeah. We can practice use wire marker and write on the whiteboard, and we can also show about the video of learning English learning melalui laptop and then show on in focus in front of student all students. Yes, like that. And the next section, that's about the steps of lesson plan. Okay, here saya membagi ke dalam 3 tahap. The first one steps is opening. It's just 15 minutes for opening. Yes, 15 minutes. And the next about the next section, 60 minutes for explanation my material yang akan disampaikan to my students. And the last section, the closing, is just 15 minutes. So here saya membagi ke dalam 3 tahapan untuk menyampaikan rencana pembelajaran, rencana yang pembelajaran yang akan disampaikan kepada my students. And the last about assessments of learning results, here I get 2 assessments. The first one assessment is about assessment of knowledge, and the second assessment is assessment of skill. In the assessment of knowledge, we can give our student multiple choice and essay. And the assessment of skill, we can give our students practice of English, of their English, or project of of their tasks and the other. Okay, I think that's about assessment of learning results. And the last is conclusion. So in this conclusion, saya lebih mengedepankan dalam my lesson plan, yeah, so that my students can understand how to understand about the present and the structure, and how to practice to the other people, and my student can menggunakan bahasa Inggris correctly. I think that's all from me. Thank you for your attention. I'm sorry, I'm many mistakes. Thank you for your attention. And the last I say, wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.